Hello dear friends, this is Dr. Deepesh Patel and I will be teaching you Advanced Internal Combustion Engine. In today's video session, we are going to cover the chapter called Emissions from IC Engine and its Control. Particular for this video session, we are going to see what are the different methods and devices for emission control. In the previous session, we have gone through what are the different types of the emissions are and what are their effects on the human being and overall ecological system. And here we try to see to control these emissions. So let's start with the different methods with the or devices for emission control. And the first one is by changing the design of engine. Here some of the suggestions are given which can be implement to control the emissions which emitted from the vehicles. First one is by increasing the air fuel ratio. Now in previous session we have understood that most of the HC and carbon monoxide emissions has been created because of the availability of oxygen. Since adequate amount of the oxygen is not available, in that case the emissions of HC and CO is highest. So if we increase the air fuel ratio, then we could have the good amount of the oxygen, proper amount of the oxygen to air and fuel mixture, and in that case we can reduce both HC and CO emissions. Second one is by reducing the compression ratio. If the compression ratio is lower, then the emissions of HC will also reduces, because due to the high compression ratio, a lot of amount of fuels may escape from the combustion chamber and enter into the crevice volume. It can also be absorbed by the film of the oil. So if the compression ratio reduces, then we can solve these problems and we can reduce the HC emissions. Third one is by retarding the ignition timing. By retarding the ignition timing, we can reduce the overall temperature inside the combustion chamber, and if the temperature inside the combustion chamber reduces, then the emissions of NOx will also reduces. Next one is by reducing the quench area. We know that due to the quenching, some of the fluid will remain unburned, unreacted, and they would leave when the exhaust valve opens. So if the quenching area would reduce, then in that case the overall emissions would also be reduced.
The next one is by reducing the valve overlap. For the certain microsecond, for the certain period of time, both inlet and open valve is remain open for the scavenging effect. If we can reduce that time period, if we can reduce the overall valve overlap time period between the inlet and exhaust valve, then we can reduce the emission as well. Then after, by increasing the engine speed. If the engine speed is increased, then overall turbulence will also increase, and that would provide the good amount of air and fuel mixture, and in that case we can reduce the emissions of HC. And the next one is by alternation in fuel supply system. There are a few modern fuel supply system has been adopted by the industries, and these would reduces the overall emissions into the atmospheres, such as multi-point fuel injection system as compared to the or over the carburation, conventional carburation system. So these are the methods and to reduce the engine emission control from the engine. Next one is a treatment of the exhaust gases. Now we know that the gases would release from the atmosphere, that would leave the engine and release into the atmosphere straight away. But if we do certain treatments of these gases before it enter into the atmosphere, then we can also reduce the emissions. And one of the method is afterburner. In afterburner, basically additional amount of fuel air is supplied, and these air will provide the good amount of oxygens, where again the whole mixture is ignited with the help of supplying the fuels by ignition sources. And then after, all the remaining emissions such as HC and CO emissions can also be successfully converted into the unharmful gases or non-objectionable gases. So afterburner is a method to burn the gases once it leave the engine. Then next one is by exhaust manifold reactor. Now exhaust manifold reactor is also a modified version of the afterburner, in which we supply the secondary air to the exhaust gases, and those gases are burned with the help of the secondary air. Since it has a certain amount of chemical energy, so we can supply the good amount of oxygens to mix with these chemical, and we can ignite it again, and overall the HC reductions emissions can be reduced, and that would be converted into the certain amount of the non objectionable gases. Then after, the exhaust gas recirculation, which is also known as the EGR method. In EGR method, we can specifically control the NOx emissions. Basically, in EGR system, what we do, we reduce is the temperature of the combustion chamber. We can reduce the average temperature of combustion chamber by supplying the exhaust gases back into the inlet manifold. So, as you can see in this diagram, the exhaust gases which come out from the engine would be taken into the reaction zones or the thermal reactor, where the reactions takes place, and then these gases, certain amount of these gases would be bleeded from the exhaust line and supply into the intake manifold through the EGR control valve. So EGR control valve basically supply the amount of gases which is been introduced into the inlet manifold. So the control of these exhaust gases would not affect the overall performance of the engine. For example, if we required the good amount of the power or throttling, then in that case EGR would stop the exhaust gases to be entered into the inlet manifold, and in normal cruising time EGR would supply the certain amount of the exhaust gases. So overall, the inlet air and fuel mixture would be diluted with supplying the exhaust gases, and that would reduce the overall temperature inside the combustion chamber, and that ultimately reduces the NOx emission, nitrogen oxide emissions from the engine. Then after, water injections. Water injection is another method to supply or to reduce the NOx emission. In water injection system, the water is injected into the intake manifold. Basically, its ratio is in between 10% to 30% to the air fuel mixture, and it is been injected into the intake manifold before it enter into the combustion chamber. So this is how we can reduce the overall or average temperature of the engine, and we can reduce the NOx emissions. Then after, there are a few other methods which can control the HC, hydrocarbon emissions. So there are three basic types of the emission control system, such as the pre-combustion, then post-combustion, and evaporating control system. In pre-combustion control, we can provide the positive crankcase ventilation, which is also known as the PCV. In PCV, all unburned hydrocarbons which has been collected into the crankcase would be taken through the proper amount of the pipeline back to the intake manifold. So all the HC emission which would certainly going to escape into the atmosphere would be taken back into the intake manifold and allowed to be entered into the combustion chamber for the ignition. So there won't be any unburned hydrocarbon from the crankcase. Second one is by providing the engine modification system, in which the secondary air or air injector systems are used to supply the adequate amount of the oxygen into the combustion chamber, and we can reduce the incomplete possibility of the incomplete combustions, and we can reduce the HC emission. Also, catalytic converter is one of the good idea to reduce the HC emission. It not only control the HC emission, but it control all three different types of the emissions from the engine. And the last one is by providing the evaporative control system, in which it traps the fuel vapors from fuel tanks, manifolds, and carburetor, or the multipoint fuel injection system. So basically, we know that the certain amount of the fuels gets evaporate from the pipeline of the fuel through the fuel tank, and they may get escape into the atmosphere. So if anything anything would be converted into the vapor, then it would be trapped by using the evaporative control system, and then this vapor would be supplied into the combustion chamber for the ignition. So this is how we can reduce the HC emission by providing three different methods. Next one, and one of the concrete solutions to reduce the overall emission, is a catalytic converter. Now, catalytic converter would reduce all three harmful gases such as HC, CO and NOx, and it would be converted into the non-objectionable gases such as H2O, CO2 and nitrogen. So, catalytic converter is basically consist of the body of the steel which has some catalytic materials such as rhodium, palladium, platinum, and these materials would does the oxidation inside the combustion inside the catalytic converter and would reduce these emissions. So such as the palladium and platinum is used to reduce the HC and CO emission, while rhodium is used to convert the NOx emission into the nitrogen. Catalytic converter is basically consist of the ceramic honeycomb structure, and that has the catalytic points embedded on it, and these fuel gases would passes over these catalytic material, and there would be oxidation since it would be come into the contact with each other. So catalytic converter would reduces all three different emissions from the exhaust gases and convert into the water, carbon dioxide and nitrogen. Next one is what are the different standards of Bharat stage emissions. Now, Bharat stage emissions is basically a standard that is instituted by the government of India to regulate the output of the emission which has been come out from the engine, different types of the engine such as the compression ignition engine and the spark ignition engines. Basically, these standards of Bharat stage emission would be changed in between different time period, and they would have a different restrictions for the different stages such as BS1, BS2, BS3. Currently, we are having the vehicles of Bharat stage 6, and it would be implemented and set by the Central Pollution Control Board under the Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. So, Bharat stage emission standard has been derived from the Euro standard from the Europe, and it was initially set into the year 2000. So, it was implemented in year 2000, and the reference was Bharat stage 1 or India 2000, and that was derived from Euro 1. Then after, with time to time, since the pollution is increasing and the number of vehicle were also increasing, so with time to time these stages were upgraded such as BS2, BS3, BS4, BS5 was actually skipped, and currently we are having the BS6, Bharat stage 6, which has been derived from Euro 6 as going on into the India. This is all. If you have any doubt regarding the emissions and different method or devices to control the emissions, you can write down in the comment box. Thank you very much.